10 up to 11, Krishna says, Brahman alone is in the form of Jiva. So, Paramatma Brahmaiva Jiva Rupena Sarvatra Sarvam Anubhavati. This is from verse number 7 to 11. Then from verse number 12 to 15, Krishna says, Brahman alone is in the form of the inert universe also. Brahmaiva jagadrupena api sarvaihi anubhuyate. Of this, we are now seeing the first part, Brahman alone is in the form of Jiva. And in this particular person, as I said in the last class, Krishna is referring to himself as Brahman. And therefore, the word Brahman is replaced by the word I in the first person singular. Therefore, whenever we hear the word Aham or I, we should replace it by the word Brahman. Therefore, Krishna said, Mamaiva amsho jiva loke jiva bhutas sanatanaha manashashthanindriyani prakritisthani karshati shariram yadavapnoti yachapyutkramati swaraha grihi tvaitani sanyati vayur gandhani vashayat. I, the original all-pervading consciousness alone, am present in every living being as the reflected consciousness, the Chidabhasa Chaitanyam obtaining in the mind. And this Chidabhasa alone makes the very body sentient and alive. Just as the pervading electricity alone makes the filament bright, and the brightness of the filament alone makes the bulb bright. So when I am appreciating the light, my mind has to appreciate the invisible electricity which is expressing as the light in the bulb, as the motion in the fan, as the magnifying power in the mic, as the heat in the, what you call, the ironing machine. So different expressions I experience, but they are all what? The blessings of the one invisible electricity. Similarly, all our physical bodies are like bulb, very fragile. And our subtle body, the sukshma shariram, is like the filament. And Atma or Brahman is like the electricity. Brahman is electricity, chulivudadengo. Brahman is comparable to electricity. Bulb is visible, filament is visible, electricity is invisible. Similarly, body is visible, mind is partially visible, whereas consciousness is invisible. But the presence of electricity can be discerned through the functions of the bulb, fan, mic, radio, television, etc. Similarly, if all of us are alive and sentient, as Taittiriya Upanishad says, Kohyevanyat kaf pranyat yadesha akasha anando nasyat yesha hyevananda yati. If our breath is going out and coming in, all these are because of the Chidabhasa obtaining within. And Chidabhasa itself is possible because of the original Chit. And therefore Krishna says, every function of every organ reveals the presence of Brahman. And this is said beautifully in Keno Upanishad, Shrotrasya Shrotram Manaso Manoyat Vachoha Vacham Sau Pranasya Pranaha. Prana is prana because of the presence of consciousness. Eye is an eye because of the presence of consciousness. Ear is ear because of that. And this Chidabhasa alone leaves the physical body at the time of death, after which alone the body, which is so sacred, which is so divine, which is very much decorated, bathed and shampooed and painted and lipsticked and all. All those things we do because it is alive. But the moment that Chidabhasa quits, Chit quits, Cholapada, be careful. The moment the reflected consciousness leaves along with the reflecting medium. What is the reflecting medium? The mind is the reflecting medium. The mind leaves the body. The Chidabhasa leaves the body. The sacred body has become an impure corpse. Shankaracharya says, Bharya bibhyati tasmin kaye. Yavat pavano nivasati dehe, tavat prichati kushalam gehe, gatavati vayau deha paye. Bharya bibhyati tasmin kaye. It has become ashaucham, and the sooner it is disposed, the better it is. What makes the difference between the dead body and live body? The scientists, the doctors can only say the functions have stopped, but they can never say what was responsible for these functions and what has left the body, they don't know. They cannot understand what is life. They cannot understand what is death. All others, they know. All others, na enna irukku? Irukkirathu rendu dhaan. And when the Chidabhasa leaves, it takes all the pancha jnanendriyani, pancha karmendriyani, and goes to another body, and it starts its puttikadai sollalalyo. It starts its business. And that is said beautifully, Chariram yadavapnoti yachapi utkramati ishvaraha. This Chidabhasa, the jiva, is called Ishvara. Here the word Ishvara means what? The jiva which is the lord of the body. And when this jiva leaves this body, and shariram avapnoti takes another body, change of residence. Avlodha, change of residence for which we make such a big fuss. And the vadakai is karma. Punya papa prarabdham is the rent. The local dollars you cannot pay. Punya papa prarabdha is the rent. When that is gone, it goes to another body. How does it go? Along with a huge lorry of all the thing. And he gave the example, Vayur Gandhani Vashayat. Just as the invisible wind carries the fragrance from the visible flower, the invisible Chidabhasa carries the fragrance of life. In the body, the fragrance is not powders, no. The body, the fragrance is the very life. So, carries the life from the visible body and goes to another setup. And what does it do there? Again start the whole business of LKG, UKG, college, get married, get children, get grandchildren, then what? Pop off. And then what? Again go to another place, LKG, UKG, ibadi poyinde irukku. Continuing, Shrotram Chakshusparshanancha. Rasanam Granamevacha. Adhishthaya Manaschayam. Vishayanupasevate. So this invisible Chidabhasa, the reflected consciousness, carries the entire sukshma shariram, and the sukshma shariram includes all the organs, pancha jnanendriyani, pancha karmendriyani, pancha pranaha, manaha, buddhihi, all the sense organ it carries. Sense organ means not the eyeball, it doesn't carry the eyeball, but behind the eyeball, the perceptive power is there, which is called the sense organ that is taken. And when a new body comes, and there also, only if the next body is a human body, all the five sense organs can be used. But if it is a tree body, the tree does not have five sense organs. So the tree has got only what? The skin part alone is there, and therefore the other four sense organs are in the tree, but they don't have the physical part for utilization. So therefore the sukshma sharira of the tree have got all the sense organs, but they don't have the physical medium for utilization. So here Krishna assumes the jiva goes to another human body. That is the assumption. And in that human body, what does it do? The chakshurindriyam is placed in the chakshur golakam. The shrotra indriyam, the invisible part, is fixed on the shrotra golakam, which is called the physical part. Indriyam is invisible part, golakam is the visible part. Similarly, tvak, chakshuhu, rasana, all of them are placed in the respective slots that is said here. Shrotram, chakshuhu, shrotram the ear, chakshuhu eye, sparshanam the skin. Skin means the invisible organ of touch. Then rasanam, the invisible organ of taste, and granam, the organ of smell. All of them are placed in the respective golakas. And also adhishthaya manaha cha. All the sense organs have to be backed by the mind, and therefore the mind also must be located appropriately. And according to the shastras, hridayam is the location of the mind, not the brain. According to shastra, hridayam is the golakam for the indriyam called mind. Which hridayam? The physical heart only. So the physical heart is the golakam, Because Golakam should be visible or invisible. Golakam must be the tangible part of the body. The tangible physical heart is the Golakam. Mind is the Indriyam which is located there. Adishtaya. Adishtaya means what? Resorting to all the six organ. Pancha Jnanendriyani plus one Antahkaranam. Resorting to all of them. What does the Jiva do? Starts experiencing the new environment. If the parents are wonderful parents, the child will have gala time. The parents are terrible parents, kandatthu galla adipa odapathittuva. Poor innocent child starts the experiences right from birth itself. And what determines the type of experience? It is not child's free will. Child was never consulted on in the parent vanama and the parent vanama shali. Spouse can be chosen by Swayamvaram, but the parents you cannot use Swayamvaram. You are already born with parents. Therefore, the innocent child's life is determined by what? Is it determined by God? No, God cannot determine. It is determined by the Purva Janma Karma. If it is Punya Karma, wonderful mom, wonderful dad, wonderful siblings, wonderful neighbor, wonderful place. If karmas are not good, we are hearing lot of child abuse and all. And the child cannot even protest. Ipata enalama purusha method la solra. The child has to silently suffer. All because of what? Purva janma, punya and papa. Depending on that, vishayan upasevate. The child experiences varieties of sense objects. Some children are born with golden spoon, some are born with silver spoon, some with ever silver spoon, some with aluminium, some with plastic, some with no spoon. It's all determined by karma. Vishayan upasevate. And remember, all these are possible. The experience of pleasures or pain, both are possible because of the Chidabhasa alone. A dead body cannot experience pleasure, nor can it experience pain. Therefore, every experience reveals the presence of life, which is Chidabhasa, which reveals the presence of Brahman, which is the Chit, the all-pervading consciousness. And therefore Krishna says, every moment of life reveals Brahman for a discerning mind. Every moment of life reveals Brahman. Just as every letter you read in your book reveals the presence of what? The light all over. The presence of light is not revealed at a particular moment. Every letter you read is because of the presence of light. Similarly, every word I speak and every word you listen is because of Brahman. And a person asks for the proof of Brahman. Enna solradhu? Like some children. So the mother would have asked, in our house, power is not there. Please go to the neighbor's house and ask, whether power is there or not. And the child is an obedient child. The child enters and the fan is on, the light is there, TV is running, all these are there. The child asks, "Enga amma vandu unga atha current iruka kekka sonna?" A child can do that. But if a grown-up person also asks, you will only laugh. Similarly, an immature person can ask for the proof of God. But for a mature person, the very question is a meaningless, ridiculous question. That is said in the next verse. Utkramantam sthitam vapi. Gunjanam va gunanvitam. Vimudhananu pasyanti. Pasyanti jnana chakshushah. So the previous verses are the preparatory verses. This is the crucial verse. So here alone Krishna says, for a discerning mind, Brahman is recognizable in every activity of the individual, in every function of the jiva. Just as the invisible electricity is discerned in every function of the electrical gadgets, in the function of the jivas, Brahman is discerned. Of course, directly we discern the function. From the function, we discern the chidabhasa, reflected consciousness. And from the reflected consciousness, we discern the original consciousness. Because we know that the original consciousness alone appears as the reflected consciousness. When you want to apply kumkumam or chandanam or vibhuti, you see the mirror and you see the face upon the mirror in front of you. And when you want to apply, you see the mirror, but apply the tilakam where? Kannadilya. Because you know that there is no difference between that face and this face. What you see is that face, but what you discern or recognize is this face. And if you find a black dot on your face, see there, but you wipe here. What does it mean? Seeing the abhasa mukham, you discern the original mukham. Similarly, I experience the abhasa chaitanyam every moment, but I understand the original consciousness. And therefore, Krishna says, mature people appreciate God in every breath. Jnana chakshushaha. People who have the eye of discernment. Because it is not the physical eye that sees the electricity. The physical eye sees only the moving fan. But I have got a third eye called Jnana Chakshuhu. And that Jnana Chakshuhu tells me that behind the visible moving fan, there is an invisible electricity blessing it. Because I know a fan by itself cannot move. If a fan can move by itself, the increase in electricity charges will not affect you. But when the power tariff is increased, we are worried. Why? Because I know that the fan by itself cannot move. Similarly, this body is like fan, and I discern through my third eye the invisible consciousness which touches the body. Jnana chakshushaha means the people who have the eye of understanding. And what is the understanding? Body is inert by itself. Mind is inert by itself. But both are now as though sentient because of an extraneous factor. That is called Atma Anatma Vivekaha. Jnana Chakshushaha, those people, Pashyanti, they discern, not through the physical eye, but the eye of understanding. What do they discern? The Chidabhasa, the Jiva, which is none other than Brahman, which has descended down. Brahman's avataram is Jiva, because the original face alone has descended down on the mirror. Similarly, Chit alone is in the form of Chidabhasa, and that Brahman they recognize. Brahman in the form of Chidabhasa. And in what all ways that Chidabhasa is playing in the body? Sthitam. First we will take the word sthitam, which is very much present in the body, keeping the body alive. So sthitam means residing in the body. What is the proof? What is the proof, Kakramali? Ardham proof? The very question is possible because the Chidabhasa or Brahman is there. And Bhunjanam, and this Jiva alone, this consciousness alone, experiences everything, Shabda, Sparsha, Rupa. Because my expression is what? I am aware of the sound. I am conscious of the form. And therefore, Chit in the form of Chidabhasa alone experiences Shabda, Sparsha, Rupa, Rasa, Gandha, which is called Bhunjanam. Bhunjanam nanartam, experiencing the world. So it resides in the body, experiences the world, and as even the experience comes, every experience generates a response. So when you hear the patas, there is a response. The one who is bursting the cracker, what is the response? Kushiyo kushi. Because he has bought only for making the sound. More sound, the merrier it is. But if you are not able to hear the word,